Hi, my name is Meg Edwards, and I'm a GTD coach. And today I wanted to share with you how I use OmniFocus, which is the tool that I use primarily to track my personal and professional commitments. And I've been using OmniFocus, I don't know, for well over a decade. And one of the reasons I chose it is I'm on a Mac. And I also love it because it allows me to link my actions and projects together when I want to do that. And there's a lot of other features that it has. But one of the things that we have people ask us all the time is, you know, what do you use as a GTD coach and how do you use it? And so this hopefully is going to be able to answer that question, at least how I do it. Now, what I love about GTD is that I have coached so many people using OmniFocus, and they all use it a little bit differently. And that's the beauty of it, is that you get to customize it. But there are some basic parts that are so important to have in OmniFocus that I find sometimes people are missing. So the way that I thought that I would start this is by looking at the workflow clarifying and organizing chart. If you have the Getting Things Done book, it's on page 123. I also just always print it out so that I have a copy of it. And we can certainly link that to the video here for people to take a look at and print out. But when I was looking to decide what I wanted to use, I needed to make sure that it had the organization buckets that I needed. So obviously I needed a place to park my projects. I needed a place to park my project plans. I love OmniFocus because it links to my calendar. The tag section allows me to customize my next actions lists, including agendas. I have a tag for waiting for. And then I had to decide what reference I wanted to keep in OmniFocus. About incubating on the someday maybe list or possibly looking into electronic tickler system, which I'll show you. And so OmniFocus for me fit all of these criterias that I needed. So now what I'd like to do is to show you how I capture, clarify, and organize into using OmniFocus. So for example, I did a little bit of a mini mind sweep, and these are five items that I captured. And when I'm clarifying and organizing, this is when I really need to slow down and really do the thinking, because when I really clarify and organize, then it's so much easier for me to review the options and to execute. So this is where I really try not to be sloppy. So for example, with Omni 4, one of the things that I want to do is I always need to then turn this into a next action, which is I want to go on Omni website and read more about Omni 4. Not going to be a project right now. And so this is something that I'm going to do in the office. Coaching manual, I need to read chapter one of the coaching manual. And that's something that I'm going to do with the office, not a project yet. January and February reports, that's also something that I need to do with the office, and I need to read and respond to Beverly regarding the January and February reports. And this is something that I'll do in the office. New deck boards. This is part of a project, which is to find a contractor, but I can't do anything about it yet. I can't get the deck boards. I don't know what deck boards to get. My car can't fit it. So this is a future action, and I'm not going to tag it because I want to attach it to my project, but it's not a next action yet. And that's the project plans with no tag. Peter, regarding contractor, Peter's my cousin, and I need to email Peter regarding who is his contractor. And that, again, is part of a project. So I'm going to attach it to that. It is a next action that I want to do, and it's something that I'm going to do in the evening. I'll start out with the ground level, which is the tag section. And this is where I track all of my next actions that I need to do when I'm by myself. And the way that I've set it up is I have a calls list and an office list and an evening list and a weekend list. This is the way that I think. This may so not be the way that you think. Maybe you like to have that computer list and separating an office list from a home list, or if you like an anywhere list, it's really kind of up to you. This is just what works for me because this is how I think. I think in terms of what calls I want to make. I think about things that I would do physically when I'm in this office and things that I would do during the day, because during the day, I'm pretty much down here in my office, whether it's personal or professional. And then there are things that I do in the evening and weekends. It's just, this is how I think. Now, I've had my lists different. Sometimes my next actions list was a computer list and an office and a home list. This is just what it looks like now because I change it up. My life changes periodically and circumstances in my life changes. The pandemic changed things for people. So what's really important is what are the lists that are going to work for you? This is what works for me. But there are a couple of things that I've learned over the years about OmniFocus to make it work for me. One is when I have a list, it's no more than a page, no scrolling up and down, too much volume for me. When I'm going to look at things like in the evening, these are the options that I want to see. And I don't want to see too many options, frankly. Otherwise, it's on my Sunday maybe list or I'm not going to do it because I don't want to be overwhelmed and I want to look at it. I want it to be attractive. And so these are the options that I want to see in the evening. And I clean this up in my weekly review to make sure that it's active, that it attracts me, that I've done all the heavy lifting and the thinking of it. And then I also have a list to do of things to do with my sister. I have a sister that lives around the corner from me. And I only want to see those things when I'm with my sister. So very simple, very easy that I can just scroll down and say, do I want to make any calls? I'm not going to show you my office because there's confidential things on there. That these are the things I want to do in the evenings, and these are the things that I want to do on the weekend. My agendas list are for things that I want to talk to people about. So when I get on the phone with my kid, these are things that I might want to talk to her about or things that I want to talk to the contractor about. I like it because every person, I just hit the plus sign and I add a tag, and then I just nest it under agenda so I can open and close it. I also have a waiting for list. Again, this is confidential information, so I'm not going to show it to you. But I separated it out from just a generic waiting for list versus a waiting for list for Beverly, who supports us at GTD Focus. And then I have errands. And I do like to divide my errands out by places that I go on a frequent basis. And then I also have this weird errands list. I have a second home that I share with my sister that's about 50 minutes away. And there's all these errands that I want to do between here and there. Morningside is the name of the house. And so many times I get to the house and I'm like, oh, I could have done this errand or I could have done that errand. So I have that. And then I have a someday maybe list for those things that are one-offs. There's some days that I would look at in my weekly review and move back to any of these other tags. So that's how I've set it up. For me, it's very simple, very easy, and it's very attractive for me to go in and to decide to see my options when I'm going to do work. But then I have the whole project section, which I don't just use for projects. I will also go into on another video all these other folders that I use, but for the purposes of this one, I just want to just really kind of do the ground level and the project level. But for example, here's a list of my personal projects. I do separate out my personal and professional projects. So again, you're coming into my world here. What I love about OmniFocus is I can have a project that has a lot of next actions, but I don't have to tag them because I don't want to do them yet or I can't do them yet. So I am working on a new project about getting clean and current in the house, which is really all of these little things that I need to do for my dad's estate and just some leftover things that I need to get clean and current on. But you can see that I've only tagged three of them. Because when I look at my tag section, I just want to see those options. I don't want to see all these other options because I'll get very overwhelmed. So I only tag the ones that I want to do, that I have the bandwidth and resources to do. Anything else on a project is untagged because that's, if you go back to the workflow map, that's project plans. And this is one of the great things that I love about OmniFocus is it gives me kind of two ways to prioritize. I can go to the ground level and say, do I want to make any phone calls? Or I could go to the project level and say, do I want to work on any of these projects? Oh, I'd like to work on, look into hiring a painter. And these are two next actions that I want to do. And that is how, generally speaking, I use OmniFocus to capture, clarify, and organize so that I can review my options to decide how I want to prioritize.